I just got a message from my ex-husband's attorney, and the harassment continues. You know, there's a lot of good people out there who are helping me right now. Oh, I just came outside. It's starting to sprinkle. It's gonna rain. I just got a message from my ex-husband's attorney, and the harassment continues. You know, there's a lot of good people out there who are helping me right now. There's a lot of good people out there helping me with their prayers. And there's a lot of good friends that my husband and I had who know what's happening to me, and knows what false allegations are being claimed by my ex-spouse, and the harassment that I'm having done to me, and they know that I don't have much, and there's a lot of people out there at my church and at my husband's church that are trying to guide me as I'm struggling emotionally due to the financial abuse from my ex-spouse and his family. And they're help advising me on sticking with biblical truth, and they're helping me with these allegations, and they're just helping me with my mental state when it comes to dealing with things that you are being accused of but you can't control, and that the justice system doesn't listen, they don't care, and you're just another number, and when you have nothing and you feel like nothing, but yet you're a Christian and you know the truth. And you've got God's word here that is telling you, you know, that you need to act a certain way to your enemies. You need to love your enemies. And especially in a marriage, when you did love your husband or when you did love your spouse, and you still do. And it doesn't change things, even if they're evil to you. I am reading scripture right now for Friday Fun Day, and I wanted to add something that I'm reading. It has to do with what I'm dealing with my ex-husband claiming everything that I had. Has nothing to do with my child, has nothing to do with anything, but he wants to be in control. I got news for him and his family who watches my videos. God is in control, not you. And when you're going through what I'm going through, it's really hard to keep your focus on God. At this moment, I haven't given you guys details of what I had to go through the last 3 years in my divorce. I've given you summaries here and there. And all I gotta say is the truth will set you free. This right here will set you free. And I'm reading in Deuteronomy about the tithing and giving back to God. You know, I have said I want to start a ministry helping other single moms. There is no reason for any woman to have to go through the emotional abuse, financial abuse, and the injustice abuse that I've had to go through. Every community service person I have spoken to says that I should not have to be going through this. Every Christian advisor that I've talked to who knew me, who knew my husband and my marriage, they said this is wrong, what I'm having to go through. It's evil, what I'm having to go through. And God releases the debtors. And it says, release for the debtors is what I'm reading right now in Deuteronomy 15. At the end of every 7 years, thou shalt make a release. So there's 7 years of good, there's 7 years of bad. And this is the manner of the release. Every creditor that lendeth aught unto his neighbor shall release it. He shall not exact it from his neighbor or of his brother, because it is called the Lord's release. Of a foreigner thou mayest exact it again, but that which is thine with thy brother and thy hand shall release it. Save when there shall be no poor among you, for the Lord shall greatly bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee for the inheritances to possess it. Only if you carefully hearken into the voice of the Lord God to observe to do all these commandments which I command thee this day. For the Lord thy God blesseth thee and promiseth thee, and thou shalt lend to many nations. Thou shalt not borrow, thou shalt not reign over many nations, but thou shalt not reign over thee. If there are among you a poor man of one of thy brethren within thy gates in thy land, which the Lord hath given thee, thou shalt not harden thy heart, nor shine thy hand from thy poor brother. But thou shalt open thy hand wide unto him, and shall surely lend him significant for his need, in which they hath wanteth. Beware that there be not thought in thy wicked heart, saying, the seventh year, the year of release, is thy hand, thy eye be evil against thy poor brother, and thou givest them not, and he cry unto the Lord against thee, and it be sin unto thee. Thou shalt surely give him, and thy heart shall not be grieved when thou grievest unto him, because that for that thing that the Lord, that God bless thee in all thy works, and unto thou puttest thy hand unto, for the poor shall never cease out of the land. Therefore I command thee, saying, thou shalt open thy hand wide unto thy brother, to thy poor, and to thy needy in thy land. So when you have people in your life, whether it be an ex-husband, a mother-in-law, or family members or friends that are wanting to take from you financially, and they're wanting to be greedy, a hateful heart towards you. We are commanded as Christians to not be that way to people in our lives, especially our spouses or ex-spouses for that matter. You know, when I was married, I was feeling this unequalness in my marriage, and I knew early on after we were married of sin, and I felt conviction for almost 10 years of sin that my husband had brought into the marriage. And as a single mom now, I thought that since we're divorced and we're separated, not by my choice, but my ex-spouse, that I would be released from the decisions of my ex-spouse and that hatefulness. It's gotten worse. It's gotten worse since the divorce. The sin has gotten worse since the divorce. The hardened heart has gotten worse. And this is a problem amongst Christians. Bible says do not take each other to court as Christians. Bible says help the poor. Don't make the poor poorer. Don't make false allegations. Don't have adulteries. Don't do these things that I am having to go through right now. But God's word also says that he will provide. He'll take care of us. He will give us everything we need. He will intervene. And I just want to say thank you right now to those in my life who are praying for me. Thank you for those in my life who are supporting me as I am losing everything, as I am going homeless again by the decisions of my ex-spouse. I'm without words, really, on the struggles that I'm going through as a single mom. I am without words of the injustice and the evilness, and as a Christian myself, I need to keep my focus on what's right. Surround myself with those other believers who are like-minded, who will lift me up in the times that I'm in. And I know that there's good marriages out there, and I know that God can give us a spouse in our life who has a kind heart, who loves their spouse, who would never leave them or forsake them. I know that there are men out there who are stepping it up and who are taking care of their families and their children. And there are men out there who are following God's word. But there are a lot of poor Christian single moms out there who are struggling. And I have joined a lot of Facebook groups of single moms, and we're discussing, you know, what do we do as single moms? How do we get out of these situations that we're in. And as a Christian, I want to help support the other Christian moms. This week, I have gone on full government assistance. But I am going to tell you that the government is not your savior. They can't help you. They are not going to be the ones who will redeem you. They can't redeem your marriage. They can't save you and you're drowning. That you're dealing with because of the decisions of your ex-spouse as a single parent. Only God can. God is the ultimate judge in your life. And I'm trying to take what has meant for evil and turn it into good, you know, with relying on Him. You know, Jesus Christ as my Savior. And my husband now. And it's a sad day for America. As of yesterday, there was conviction of President Trump of false allegations against him. And unconstitutional ruling. And I firmly believe we're going to start seeing the downfall of America as a downfall of not following Jesus Christ in a family. You're going to have a broken family. You are going to be ripped away from having that godly home and that godly marriage if your spouse and you are unequally yoked. If the spouse, the leader of the family, leaves that family, you as a mom and as a Christian single woman, you're going to have to do what's right for your family and step it up. This is one of the hardest things as a Christian is 100% surrendering everything, your marriage, your children, your finances to God and let Him be in control. And it doesn't matter if you are in jail. It doesn't matter if you are living in a shelter. It doesn't matter if you are on your own. God is the one who will provide for you. And maybe He'll change the heart of that spouse. Maybe there will be salvation of that spouse, and that spouse will no longer be living in sin, and that spouse will come to know God and turn and restore your marriage. I've heard a lot of stories of that happening. But as a Christian single mom, we need to be praying for that. We need to be praying for redemption in our lives, for the truth in our lives, for the justice, the fair and just system to work. If the justice system is going to take God out of the justice system, which it has, the justice system is corrupt and it will fall. And they don't care who they hurt in the process. They're not going to care who goes down in the process. That's why there's no hope and help out there for a lot of people who rely on the system. It will fail you. the times that we're living in, we cannot, as single moms, rely on anyone else other than Jesus Christ. And we need to use the time that we have left here to be a witness. That's why I'm making these videos, to share my journey, these things that are happening to me and these things that I'm having to deal with in my life. Not having any income coming in and not being able to live without that support. We as single moms need to do what we need to do to take care of our children the best we can. And if that other person in the marriage takes away your rights as a parent, just know that it's not by anything that you've done. It's sin. And you can't expect anything less from a non-believer. And if you're dealing with court battles, you can't expect anything else from a non-believer. One of the things that these single moms that I'm talking to are dealing with is the depression of, why is this happening to me? What is going on? And my feelings on that is because it's meant to be. It's happening because we are not in control of our lives. God is. And yes, we get to make decisions on how we're going to handle the circumstances that come upon us. But God is the one who will remove you from situations that are pure evil. And I believe in my divorce, that's exactly what happened. The evilness that I'm facing post-divorce was in my marriage. And God removed me from that. He saved me and He protected me. And He's provided for the last 3 years. I've done amazing. With God as the leader of my family. And I know that moving forward, He's going to take care of me. There's no doubt in my mind. I just don't know how much time we have left. And so I feel like we need to stand up for what's right. We need to stand up for justice. We need to stand up for the Constitution of the United States of America. Because it's going down. One day it will no longer be held. And we as poor single moms with low incomes, we need to do what we need to do, like a mother feeding her baby bird, you know? Make the sacrifices that you have to fight for what's right, to feed your children and take care of them and clothe them. But you're not a bad mom because you're poor. You're not a bad mom because you are having false allegations against you. It doesn't make you a bad mother. So we need to stand strong on our faith. We need to stand strong in the lies of Satan. Satan himself will attack you if you are a Christian. So be prepared for that. Get your homes in order. We don't have a whole lot of time left. And I wanted to make a Friday Fun Day video for you guys. But to be honest with you, this Friday, it's raining right now on me. My cat has escaped. I gotta go chase her down. But I am going to church tonight to listen to a speaker with Daughters of the King. And I am knowing that the speaker is going to speak to me. And it's a missionary. And, you know, I think of those missionaries who are coming from other countries that are poor and, You know, we think we got it so bad here in America, but we really don't. And we just need to be very grateful for the things we have. I look back at the 3 years since my husband filed for divorce and kicked us out of the house. Yeah, I've done good. I've done good on my own. I am at a point where I no longer can financially afford to live. And sacrifices are gonna have to be made. What are the options? I have talked to Salvation Army about transitional housing as I'm struggling right now. We are at a point in society in America where we are spending thousands and billions of dollars on other countries and helping them, and we're not taking care of our own country. And as a single mom, I do not want to do that for my family. I'm going to take care of my family first. And so these decisions in my life right now are not fun on this Friday. The email I just received is not fun for me. But I know what's the truth. And I do know that the truth will set me free. And I have nothing to stand on anymore with the lies from Satan, except for the truth. And we need to stand up as Christians in our faith. And just like I just read in the Bible, you know, if they say you are a debtor, you owe money to someone, or you're going to go to jail. You know what? God is the release. I just read it in Deuteronomy 15. God is the release. The Lord is the release, is what it says. And He paid the debt for us. He died on the cross for our sins. And to think of a man paying the debt, taking care of his family, taking care of his wife, doing whatever it takes to take care of his child. I have a friend who, her and her ex-husband are best friends, you guys. They're best friends. And I sit there and I look at them and I'm like, how do you do that? Like, I can't even get mine to talk to me without his attorney or without his mother holding his hand. And I think that we were married for almost 10 years and he has turned his back on God so much he can't even face his own demons in him, cannot face his own sin. And I think of the fear of the bondage of sin holds over people and how they don't act normal, how they don't act reasonable, and how they don't take care of their responsibilities, the things that God has given to them. And I can be free knowing that I am following the one who releases me of that bondage. And I can be free knowing that I've tried everything I can. And I've been a great mom. I was a great wife. I was a good friend, a good daughter. And no matter what life brings me, I know that God is gonna guide me and He's gonna show me what to do in my life. So I hope that this is encouraging to you. This is just something God laid on my heart because I just received that email. And it doesn't even matter because my debt has been paid by Jesus. And you know, life's not fair. So as a single mom, we're gonna have to pull up our big girl bridges, face the music, and let God be in control. When I think of letting God be in control, it gets very exciting. That becomes a Friday fun day. When I think, look at what God's gonna do in my life. He is going to provide that miracle that I need. He's going to give me the things I need. He's going to provide. He's going to show me a way. Change is scary. Losing your home is scary. Owing $33,000, $35,000 in debt. It's a scary thought for a single mom who has no job, who is going on disability. Very scary. But you know what? I surrender everything to Him, not anyone else. And that's freeing, that's fun, and it's exciting. And I am excitingly anticipating what's to come. And I got a home. It's in heaven with Jesus, because He's coming back for His bride. He's going to take care of His bride. He's going to be committed to His vows. He is going to keep His promises. He is going to show His love. And He's going to heal. And He is going to give me the desires of my heart. When I think of that marriage covenant, that's how it should be. When I think of a marriage and a family, and when I think of love, that's how we are to show love towards others, is keep our word and our promises, do what's right, pray about things, and support one another, lift each other up. And so that's the change that you guys are going to start seeing on this channel. You're going to start seeing more of my faith incorporated into my daily living, what I'm going through in life, whatever it may be, and wherever I may go, as I am going to have to downsize my life. You are going to see me struggle, to be honest with you guys. So be very prepared for that. And we're still going to have Friday Fun Day. And we are still going to rejoice. For God is good. His mercies are new every morning. And this is the day the Lord hath made. Even in the rain, I'm going to rejoice and be glad in it. And He makes all things beautiful in His time. Remember that. Bye.